which can be tricky when you've got a portfolio sensitive to rate changes. So how do you deal with that? Mark Freeman, CIO and Portfolio Manager at Westwood Holdings Group, joins me now. So it's nice to have you here.
My pleasure.
Especially with everything that's happening on the interest rate front,
right,
because you really focus on dividends and mm-hmm. yields. How does that all change? You know, how's that changed from May when we had a different
right.
picture?
Well, I think if you kind of go back in time when rates were so extremely low, we obviously saw in the market there was a push to the very much yield-oriented components of the market. So what is changing now as rates are coming up, and what we're doing in the portfolio is, and what we really have always done, is we want the income component, but we also want a growth component, because that growth component is what I think will serve as an offset as interest rates, should they continue to rise, which we think they probably will, but that growth component will actually provide some cushion, if you will, going forward.
So what asset classes are you in now?
That's a great question. We actually use eight different asset classes, and so the things that you would expect, for example, dividend-paying stocks and obviously fixed income. We use royalty trusts. We also use master limited partnerships, preferreds, converts, and cash, which I do consider an asset class.
You have more cash now than in the past?
We do. I'm actually, right now we're using cash almost as a substitute for fixed income. Mm-hmm. Because one thing I do want to say.
You're not alone, right?
Yeah, exactly right. It's an issue of I'd rather have no return than a negative return. And that's basically the trade-off right now between cash and fixed income. So you may say, well, look, why do you want something with no return? And I think one of the things that's important to understand is that within the mandate of the fund is that we also want to maintain a low volatility profile. And cash helps us to do that right now.
One of your biggest equity sector holdings is financials. Mm-hmm. Now, is that something you might consider adding to in a rising rate environment?
It is, and it's actually an area where we have been adding to there. Because we also want to look and say, well, look, what parts of the market or what type of companies actually going to benefit from a rising rate environment? And financials are one. We've added USB, U.S. Bank Corp. So is a one that is the yield curve steepens. Now, they're not going to see that impact immediately, but as we look out 2, 3, 4 quarters forward, we think that impact will start to flow through.